Hi everyone! Welcome to my YouTube channel where you can find videos that will make math more fun and easy for you to become winner in numbers, winner in life. Hi! Once again, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Roel Carpio. I'm a math teacher and a coach, and I do math tutorial in my YouTube channel. If it is your first time to visit my channel, kindly hit the subscribe button found below, and don't forget to hit the notification bell button for you to be notified every time I upload new video. And if you think that the content of my YouTube channel is worth sharing with others, kindly share it with them, and don't forget also to leave a comment on the comment section found below. Thank you! In this video, I'm going to continue my discussions on how to subtract mixed numbers. In my previous video, I discussed how to subtract mixed numbers in which the denominators are similar and the minuend is bigger than the subtrahend. This time, we shall now have subtraction of mixed numbers in which the fractional parts are not similar and the minuend is smaller than the subtrahend. So let us have example number one. So what if we are subtracting, let's say, 5 1/3 minus 2 1/2. Okay, the same process, when we are subtracting mixed numbers, we can start subtracting the whole numbers. So in this case, we have 5 minus 2, and then we can also subtract the fractional part, which are 1/3 and 1/2. So 5 minus 2 will give us 3. But 1/3 minus 1/2, we cannot immediately subtract since the denominator are not the same or they are dissimilar fractions. So therefore, we have to identify the LCM of 3 and 2. And the LCM of 3 and 2 is 6. And we are going to use the LCM 6 as our common denominator of the two fractions. Now, we have to identify the numerators of the two fractions. Let's start with 1/3. This 3 to become 6, we have to multiply it by 2. So therefore, we have to multiply also 1 by 2. So 1 times 2 will give us 2. Here, for this 2 to become 6, we have to multiply it by 3. So therefore, we have to multiply also the 1 by 3. So 1 times 3 will give us 3. So if we look at our new fractions now, 2 6 minus 3 6, 2 minus 3 cannot be since the numerator in the subtrahend is bigger than the numerator in the minuend. So what we can do now is to rename first this 3 into 2 plus 1 and then plus 2 over 6. And then this one will be subtracted by 3 over 6. Now, this one, we can rename this further into 6 over 6 because 6 over 6 is just the same as 1. So we have 2 plus 6 over 6 plus 2 over 6 minus 3 over 6. So 6 over 6 plus 2 6 will give us 8 over 6. So 2 and 8 6 minus 3 over 6. So in other words, the 3 and 2 6 can be renamed into 2 and 8 6 so that we can now subtract our numerator by 3. So 8 minus 3 will give us 5. So therefore, our final answer is 2 and 5 over 6. So 5 1/3 minus 2 1/2 will give us 2 and 5 6. Now, let's have another example. Example number 2. So in our example number 2, we are going to subtract 7 1/2 minus 3 4/5. So again, we can start by subtracting our whole numbers, 7 minus 3, then plus. We can also subtract our fractional parts, 1/2 minus 4/5. Now, 7 minus 3 will give us 4. But then, 1/2 minus 4/5, we have to find the LCM first of 2 and 5 so that we can use the LCM as our common denominator. So the LCM of 2 and 5 is 10. So therefore, our common denominator is 10. Now, we have to identify our numerators so that it will be equivalent to 1/2. So for this 2 to become 10, we have to multiply it by 5. So 2 times 5 is 10. So we have to multiply also the numerator 1 by 5. So 1 times 5 will give us 5. So therefore, the equivalent of 1 half is 5 tenths. Now how about 4 fifths? So for this 5 to become 10, we have to multiply it by 2. So 5 times 2 will give us 10. So therefore, we have to multiply also the numerator 4 by 2. 4 times 2 will give us 8. So the same thing also, 5 tenths minus 8 tenths cannot be because the numerator in the subtrahend is bigger than the numerator in the minuend. So what we can do now is to rename first the 4 into 3 plus 1 plus the 5 over 10 and then minus that with 8 over 10. This one can be renamed further into 10 over 10. Why 10 over 10? So that it would be easier for us to add to 5 over 10 since they have the same denominators. Actually, you can use any number. Let's say you want to use 5 over 5 is equal to 1. 9 over 9 is equal to 1. So, we have to use 10 over 10 so that it would be easier for us to add to 5 over 10. So, here we have 3 plus 10 over 10 plus 5 over 10. Take note, 10 over 10 is just similar to 1. So minus 8 over 10. So here, we have 10 over 10 plus 5 over 10 will give us 15 over 10. Our new mixed number is 3 and 15 over 10 minus 8 over 10. So from 4 and 5 tenths, we rename the fraction into 3 and 15 tenths so that we can subtract our numerators by 8. So 15 minus 8 will give us 7. So our final answer is 3 and 7 over 10. So this is our final answer since 7 tenths is already in its lowest term. So 7 and 1 half minus 3 and 4 fifths will give us 3 and 7 tenths. Now let's have our next example. So in our next example, we have here 8 and 1 fourth minus 3 and 2 thirds. So the same thing, we can start subtracting the whole numbers. 8 minus 3, and then we can also subtract the fractional parts, 1 fourth minus 2 thirds. Now, 8 minus 3 will give us 5. But then, our fractional parts are not similar, so therefore, we have to identify first the LCM of 4 and 3. The LCM of 4 and 3 is 12. So, we will use 12 as our common denominator. So, then, we are going to identify the numerator that is equivalent to 1 fourth, in which the denominator is 12. So, for this 4 to become 12, we multiply it by 3. So, 4 times 3 is 12. So, 1 times 3 will give us 3. Next, for this 3 to become 12, we multiply it by 4. So, 3 times 4 is 12. So, we have to multiply also our numerator 2 by 4. So, 2 times 4 is 8. Now, if we look at our fractional parts, 3 twelves minus 8 twelves, the numerator in the minuend is smaller than the numerator in the subtrahend. So what we can do is to rename this 5 into 4 plus 1 plus 3 over 12. So minus 8 over 12. So this one here, we can rename this further into 12 over 12. Because 12 over 12 is just simply equivalent to 1. So 12 over 12, why 12 over 12? So that we can immediately add to 3 twelves. So here, we have 4 plus 12 over 12 plus 3 twelves minus 8 over 12. So 12 over 12 plus 3 twelves will give us 15 twelves. So 4 and 15 twelves minus 8 over 12. So meaning to say that 5 and 3 twelves is just the same or equivalent to 4 and 5 twelves. So 15 minus 8 will give us 4 and 7 over 12. So therefore, 8 and 1 4 minus 3 and 2 thirds will give us 4 and 7 twelfths. So that is our final answer, since 7 twelfths is already in its lowest term. So I hope that you have learned and enjoyed watching this video. See you again in my next video. Thank you.